time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. All you still more. Speed your love to me. Lonely rivers flow to the sea, to the open arms of the sea.
They came out of nowhere, boss. Ambushed our boys, killed Law, and shot Bobby. He's alive, but barely. He's pretty beaten up. Doc says he's bleeding out internally. Kids said they were after the case. They knew exactly where to look. They knew the perfect hidden spot on the car. I mean, how the fuck did they know? Sorry about my language. It just gets me when people have the cheek, the disrespect to steal from us, from you. It makes my blood boil. Luckily for us, one of our moles within the Granis boys said they found it just 2 hours later, just sitting in a bar downtown. No Latinos or nothing. Now we got no quorum with the boys, but we can't just sit on our hands and do nothing. That's why I come to you. To ask for your blessing to do what is needed to be done.
My daddy and granddaddy before him were both surgeons. They both served their country honorably, patching up everything from bullet holes to knife wounds to burns that caused some doctors to retch in disgust. But my daddy and granddaddy pushed on, undeterred. Now they had a variety of tools of the trade, like hammers and saw and pliers, dressings, each with its own purpose and job to do. When a man came in with half his leg and arm blown off, it was a case of which saw to use to get rid of the dead members. But say a guy comes in with a bullet stuck in his shoulder, well, my daddy wouldn't simply cut his arm off. Nah, instead he would use precision instruments to remove that piece of lead. Doing this saved the man's arm and life in one swoop. Now, we could take a hammer and a saw to this situation we find ourselves in, but the damage would be irreversible. Instead, using more precious tools, we can limit the lasting damage, wouldn't you agree?
Of course, ma'am. But what is our scalpel?
Let me worry about that. Thank you for bringing this to my attention. It will be dealt with. Do not raise this issue again in or outside of the office. You are excused.
Of course, ma'am. Thank you.
It's me. I require your services.
Still trying to drive that broad, huh?
Body like hers was art by itself. Trying to capture something like that takes practice. Besides, I'm doing this for your benefit. How about some gratitude?
What does I gotta tell you? How's your sketch up the girls you screwed?
I'll eat your fucking words once I get her chest right.
You know you can get these things nowadays called cameras, right?
Like, click, boom, there's all the legwork for you.
Try getting abroad to have a picture taken wearing nothing but heels and perfume. Take a better man than me.
Is that a challenge?
Bastard. Think the kid'll show?
Yeah. He'll be here.
Here we go. Let me take point on this one.
You're the guys, right?
Yep. We're the guys.
Proven. Okay, you are who you say you are. Give me glass.
First things first. I can imagine that you haven't done too many of these, so let me lay down a few ground rules. You follow them, you won't be having any problems. Capiche? Capiche? Good. Rule one. You don't pass this ball unless I say it's okay. Rule two, you do not pull a weapon of any kind. Rule three, show some respect. Got it?
And how do I know you're not just gonna blow me away? Huh?
That's how.
Now please, give me glass.
First, we want to see what you've got for us. My colleague just needs to make sure it's the genuine article. Understand.
See? I'm no liar.
Indeed you're not. No. We'll be needing the rest.
You assholes! You promised I'd get glass back!
What did I say about respect, kid? You did good getting this far. Don't cock it up now.
You know what, dirtbag? Fuck you.
What was rule number two?
So tell me where he is!
What was rule number two, kiddo, I gave you some rules, you broke them. Breaking rules means consequences.
No. I don't like to kill a man without making sure his family's provided for. I'm not gonna take away the breadwinner without providing the much needed bread. So, we pass? Is there anyone that you care for that needs looking after?
Screw you!
don't move a fucking muscle.
Coming straight to your homes, it's Billy Murray with Jimbo Jambo on KRQ 125.
One last time. Is there anyone that you care for that needs providing for?
Jimbo lives a girl named Jimbo Sambo, and they say that little Tambo steals the heart.
My little sister, Millie. She ain't got anyone else.
Mo will be looked after and provided for. I know this. You did good getting this far, kid. Most people wouldn't have. Good night, kid. See you down there.
About this little Sambo, but the women gab and gamble every time they meet.